suppose we have to see that whether the following numbers are irrational number or not. So 2 plus root 2 whole square. So if you remember, that is, you can suppose a and b, so you can use identity of a plus b whole square, that was a square. Okay, we will use this identity, that was a square plus b square plus 2ab. So we will put the value 2 square plus root 2 square plus 2 into 2 root 2. That will give you 2 square is 4 and root 2 square will give you 2. So it will be 6 plus 4 root 2. So 6 is a rational number and 4 root 2 is a irrational number. That means this whole number is a irrational number. Okay. One more type. Suppose something is given like this. Now if you see carefully, this is A, this is B, then again A and B. So if you remember one identity, A plus B into A minus B. So it was equal to A square minus B square. So again we will use this identity, 5 square minus root 5 whole square. So 5 square is 25 minus 5, that is 20. That means it is a rational number. Okay, one more type. Suppose it is given, we have to find root 7 upon 6 root 2 whole square. So when you expand it, it is root 7 into root 7. Then 6 root 2 whole square means 6 into 6 into root 2. So it becomes 7 upon 36 into 2, that is 72. Again, if you see carefully, this is a integer. This is an integer, so it is again becomes a rational number. Okay, like this you can see how to see whether the number is a rational or irrational. Because without complete simplification, you cannot say the number is a. Pause. Oh.